as far as champagne is concerned, you know, we would like at Audrey to talk about champagne as a wine. So too many people are talking about champagne like, you know, just celebration and easy wine to drink, etc., but not really very serious about the wine. Then we try to develop a real wine, not before being a champagne, it's a real wine. Brut Premier, obviously, is a blend between Pinot Noir, Chardonnay, Pinot Meunier. Two-thirds Pinot, one-third Chardonnay. Within the two-thirds Pinot, you have a little bit of Pinot Meunier, 20%. Some reserve wine aged on the oak cask. So that is to say that something very special as far as Rodre is concerned for the Brut Premier is the fact that you have some reserve wine aged on the oak. And also, Rodre is aging, Louis Rodre is aging, Brut Premier 3.5 years before shipment. So I think it's very important because this is 3 times bigger than, higher than the official recommendation in Champagne, which is 15 months. Mm-hmm. So after 15 months, you can ship the champagne. And you know, sometimes you hurt your stomach because it's very, 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 very acidic. So Louis Rodre Brut Premier is aging 3 years on lees and 6 months on cork before shipment. That's a very, very important thing. And of course, Cristal is coming from the grapes coming from our Louis Rodre vineyards, rated 100% Grand Cru de Champagne. So three villages, as far as Cristal is concerned, three villages are used for Cristal, 100% Grand Cru. The first one is Avize in the Côte des Blancs, in the Chardonnay area. Second one is Verzenay, and the third one is Ailly. Verzenay is Montagne de Reims, and Ailly is Vallée de la Marne. The three villages, Avize, Verzenay, Ailly, the three of them are 100% rated Grand Cru de Champagne. So that's very important. The Cristal is aging 6 years in our cellars, 5.5 years on lees, plus 6 months on cork. That's 6 years before shipment. But the Cristal is a very small production. We are talking here about 200,000-400,000 bottles every good vintage. Old and long history, because Cristal was created for the Tsar Alexander II in 1876. So it's very easy for Louis Rodre. You have to remember Rodre. Rodre is 1776. The creation of the company. It's easy to remember because this is the creation of the United States of America. You know, the revolution in America, that was in 1776, so it's a nice same date. 100 years after, 1876, creation of Cristal. So that was during the Tsar Alexander II time. He wanted to have a clear bottle to see inside. He was afraid to be poisoned. So, Monsieur Roderer produced with a friend in Baccarat company, Cristal Baccarat. They produce a beautiful bottle of Cristal, real Cristal, and that was the first try, and the bottle explodes because of the pressure, the champagne pressure inside. So that's why they have to change a little bit the shape of the bottle. And so now you can see the shape is flat and thick, thick bottom and flat, to resist against the champagne pressure. So this is today, obviously, not anymore a real Cristal, because otherwise it would be even more expensive. But this is a beautiful, special white glasses from the north of France. And Cristal, obviously, is the oldest cuvée de prestige in Champagne. The oldest cuvée de prestige. 2002, which was a beautiful vintage in Champagne, a very nice balance between acidity and alcohol, and sugar acidity, very nice balance. So 70% Pinot Noir, 30% Chardonnay, and the skin contact obviously is done with the Pinot Noir. And so we leave the skin and the must together for, let's say, 24 hours, 36 hours, depending on the maturity of the Pinot. And yes, the color is very pale. The color is called pelure d'oignon, onion skin. And it's not a very big pink rosé color. I don't like that.
The Pinot Noir in the mouth is...
Absolutely. It's the big fruit, the big Pinot. And, you know, I think it's very important because when you think about champagne rosé, you have to think about champagne first and rosé second. And champagne means elegance and finesse. So the champagne rosé should not be full of tannin and, you know, dark color. But the vintage 06 was a very interesting year because it was... the summer was... In 06, the summer was quite wet. especially in August, but September was absolutely beautiful. And the old people in Champagne are always saying that September is doing the wine. So the first three weeks of September, 06, was absolutely superb. So the harvest was high quality and also very dry, no botrytis in the vineyard, etc. So at the end of the day, I think 06 would be a very good vintage and very fruity vintage. A little bit like 02, no, a little bit like 04. 04 or 06, a bit like 04 or 06. Fruity and very accessible to the customers.